kids, how are you all? I hope you all must be fine, right? So today we are going to read for class 4 Science Olympiad. And in class 4 Science Olympiad, which portion we are going to discuss? We are going to discuss the previous year question paper of level 2 exam of SOF NSO. Okay, so are you all ready for it? Yes, so let's get started. Our first question, the given figure shows human digestive system with some parts labeled as P, Q, R and S. Which of the following labeled parts is correctly matched with its function? So this is the diagram here and P, Q, R, S is given. And options are A, Q, food is mixed with different digestive juices. B, P, digestion starts here. Option C, R, most of the water is absorbed here. D, S, digestion of all food components takes place here. Okay, so here we can see P is there. So P is the mouth, then Q, it is the esophagus. Okay, then R, it is stomach, and S, it is large intestine. Okay. And let us check the options now, and we have to find out the correctly matched part with its function. So here in A option, that is Q, food is mixed with digestive juices. So here Q, that is we know that is esophagus. In esophagus, no secretion of digestive juices there and no digestion takes place in esophagus. So this option is incorrect. P, digestion start here. P, that is mouth. Yes, digestion starts in mouth because the saliva that we secrete, it contains digestive juice, that is digestive enzyme, salivary amylase, its name. So it helps in digestion. So digestion starts from the mouth. Next in R, most of the water is absorbed here. R, that is the stomach. No, water is not absorbed here. In stomach, digestion takes place. Okay. And digestion of all, the most of the water absorbed, that is the large intestine. Then digestion of all food components takes place here. S, so S is the light, that is the large intestine. Here, no digestion takes place here. The water which is present, the most of the water is absorbed here. Okay, so here the correct answer is option B. Got it everyone? Coming to the next question. Four similar sized balls made of clay P, iron Q, styrofoam R and glass S respectively were put in a container as shown in the given diagram. Then some water was added to the container. Which of the following shows the correct observation after some time? So here P, Q, R, S. Sorry, these are the balls, okay, present in the container, and now we added water to it. Okay, so after addition of water to the container, which of the following shows the correct observation after some time? Okay, so here see between this P, Q, R, S, here clay, iron and glass, these are heavier than water. Okay, as these are heavier than water, so when we fill the container with water, they will come, they will settle at the bottom. Okay, and styrofoam, that is lighter than water, that's why it will float on the surface of the water. So here the correct answer is option C. Okay, coming to the next question. In which of the following cases a person is doing work in terms of science? A, Radhika is pushing against a stationary wall. B, Priya is sleeping. C, Meena is standing at bus stop waiting for her school bus. D, Gayatri is opening the main door of her house on hearing the doorbell. So we have to find in which of the following case a person is doing work in terms of science. Okay, so you know when a person is doing work in terms of science, when there is movement of the object, there is change in position of the object. Okay, so here Radhika is pushing against a stationary wall, so there is no change in position of object, so work is not done. Priya is sleeping, so it is also not the work. Meena is standing, no, it is also not the work. that Gayatri is opening the main door of her house on hearing the doorbell. So here, on hearing the doorbell, Gayatri is coming to the main door, then opening the main door. So there is change in position of the object. So here, in case that is the option D, work is done in terms of signs. Okay, coming to the next question. Study the given words of table. Which of the following sets of boxes will give the name of a cooking method X and a food preservation method Y respectively? Options are A, 11 and 7, 9 and 12, B, 4, 6 and 7, 3, 5 and 7, C, 1, 12 and 7, 2, 8 and 7, D, 6 and 10, 4 and 8. So here we have a watch of table. We have to find out which of the following set of boxes will give the name of a cooking method X and food preservation method Y. Okay, so here cooking method, a correct option is option B, 4, 6, 7, 4. That is, let me write here, ROA, then 6, yes it is 4, then 6 ST, then 7 ING. So roasting is a cooking method. Okay, next one is 3, 5, 7, 3, PI. Okay, so PI, then CKL, then 7 ING. Pickling. So pickling is a food preservation method. That's why the correct answer is option B. Coming to the next question, refer to the given diagram where X and Y represent substances while P and Q represent organs. Which of the following base represents organ P and Q and substances X and Y? Options are A, stomach, pancreas, water, undigested food. B, large intestine, stomach, digested food, water. C, large intestine, anus, digested food, water. D, stomach, large intestine, digested food, undigested food. Okay, so here a diagram is given where X and Y are the substances and P and Q represent the organs. So organ P, organ Q. So P, from P to Q, okay, there is flowing of certain things, and blood is taking X, the substance X, it is taken up by blood, and substance Y, it is going to the organ Q. So if we look into the options, then here the correct option will be, that is the most appropriate, or we can say best represent this thing, that is the option D. So here organ P, it can be stomach. So from stomach, food goes through different things, it goes to large intestine. Okay, so from the stomach it goes to small intestine, then large intestine, and your substance X, that is taken to blood, that is the digested food. So digested food, it is taken up by blood. Okay, and Y, that is the undigested food, and the undigested food, it goes to the large intestine, and from the large intestine it moves out of the body through the anus. Okay, so here the correct answer is option D. Coming to the next question, read the given paragraph with few blanks and select the option that correctly fills up any three of these blanks. Human adults have 10 types of teeth in their dentition. These are QRS and molars. Q helps in cutting or biting food. There are T, Q in each jaw. R, teeth are absent in milk teeth set, but there are useless teeth in permanent teeth set. S are 4 in number and helps in V, food. Options are A, P8, R premolars, V grinding. B, Q incisors, T4, U8. C, S canines, T8, U4. D, P8, S premolar, V tearing. So here in the paragraph, few blanks are there and we have to select the options. Okay, so human adults have P types of teeth in their dentition. So human adults, we have four types of teeth in our dentism, that is incisor, canine, premolar and molar. Four types of teeth. Next one is about, these are QRS and molars. So QRS, we don't know which one is what. Okay, so as molar is given here, so QRS, one of them will be incisor, one will be canine, one will be premolar. Let us find out which one is what. Q helps in cutting or biting food. So Q, that helps in cutting and biting food. So we can say that here. Okay, I am writing here. So Q is the incisors. Okay, Q incisors. Then there are TQ in each jaw. In each jaw, there are four incisors. Okay. Four incisors in upper jaw, four incisors in lower jaw. Two in left side, two in right side. Our teeth are absent in milk teeth. Our teeth are absent in milk teeth. In the milk teeth, premolar and molar are absent. Okay. So molar is given here. Then R, it will be the premolar. Okay. Set. But there are use such teeth in permanent teeth set. So in permanent teeth set, total 8 premolars are there. Then S are 4 in number and helps in dash 4. S are 4 in number. So S, we can say S, these are canines. Total 4 canines are there. Okay. And canines, they help in tearing food. So now we got all the plants. Okay. So which one will be the correct option? Correct answer option will be option B, Q incisor T4U8. Got it, everyone? Coming to the next question. Three plants X, Y, and Z were put into three identical containers filled with 500 ml of water as shown in the figure. Some oil was poured into each container, which formed a thin layer above water to prevent water loss through evaporation. The containers were kept outdoor at the same place. Which of the following graphs correctly depicts the volume of water in the three containers after 2 days? Okay, so here X, Y, Z, three containers are there. Water is present in the container, in all the containers, and oil is there. Why? To prevent water loss through evaporation. Okay, in each container 500 ml of water is there. Then after some time, okay, after some time, what we need to find out, which of the following graph correctly depicts the volume of water in three containers after 2 days. So after 2 days, what will happen? Whatever processes should be taken place, they will take place. Okay, so what are the processes to be taken place? See, if water is present in the beaker and oil is poured on the water, then oil will cover water. It will form a layer on the water. So evaporation, that is conversion of water to the water vapor. Okay, conversion of water to the water vapor, that we call evaporation, it will not occur because the water is covered with oil, but water will be used by the plants present here. Okay, now water will be used by the plants present here, and you know the leaves, they use water. Yes, leaves lose water, and that process is known as transpiration. Okay. So leaves uses water. So if more leaves are there, they will use more water. They will leave more water, means more transpiration will be there. More water is lost. So they will take more water from the beaker. Okay. So if more water is lost through the leaves, then root try to make up it. So root will absorb more water. So when we compare X, Y, and Z, there is less number of leaves in J. So here less water will be used. Here less water will be used. Okay. And in Y, comparatively more leaves are there. So comparatively more water will be used. In X, many leaves are there, so more water will be used. Here more water will be used. So if more water will be used from container X, then there will be less amount of water. Okay, so in container X there will be less amount of water compared to container Y compared to container Z, because the more leaves present in a container X, they will use more water. Okay, so here the correct option will be option B, least water in X followed by Y followed by Z. Got it everyone? Coming to the next question, which of the following activities will cause both air and water pollution? Option A, enhanced vehicular transport. B, bathing animals and washing clothes in water bodies. C, throwing solid waste like poly bags and tin cans in water bodies. D, burying domestic biodegradable waste underground. So which of the following activities will cause both air and water pollution? So enhanced vehicular transport, it will cause air pollution, okay, because the vehicles, they will release the more pollutants, okay, so there will be air pollution. Then when the pollutants in the air, it will increase. Then when rainfall occurs, then what happens, then these pollutants present in air, they will combine with rainwater and will form acid. Okay, got it? The pollutants present in the air, they will combine with the rainwater and they will produce acid rain. And this acid rain, it will cause water pollution. Okay, and in all the options B, that is bathing animals and wasting clothes in water bodies, here only water pollution will be there. Throwing solid waste like poly bags and tin can in water bodies, water pollution. Then burying domestic biodegradable waste and underground, it is a good, we can say good step for reducing pollution. Okay, so here the correct answer is option A. Coming to the next question, starting from the first letter, strike out every alternate letter in the given letter groups to get the name of the traditional clothing of Japanese women. So we have to, starting from the first letter, we have to strike out every alternate letter in the given letter group to get the name of the traditional clothing of Japanese women. Okay, so here the correct answer is option B. How? Just what we will do, we have to strike from the beginning. This one, this. So we are left with kimono. Okay, you know kimono, that is the traditional clothing of Japanese women. So this is the answer. Coming to the next question, X is an animal that lives inside the body of another organism of different species. It has special organ to suck blood. X could be dash. Option A, mosquito. B, hookworm. C, head louse. D, leech. So here X is an animal that lives inside the body of another organism of different species. It has specialized organ to suck blood. Okay, so what can be the X? So X can be the hookworm, which present in the body of the other organism. Okay, and it sucks blood. So correct answer is option B. Coming to the next question, refer to the given graph showing temperature changes at a place over a year, P to R, and select the correct option regarding it. Option A, people inhabiting the given place mostly wear clothes made up of fibers sourced from some mammals. B, the given area receives precipitation in the form of rain at time Q, whereas precipitation in snow from witnessed at the time P and R. C, plants like mango and people and animals like kangaroo, rat and fennec fox are commonly found at this place. D, plants inhabiting this place have thin broad leaves which lack stomata, whereas animals of this area show bright coloration and possess thin moist glandular skin. So here, see, P, Q, R. So P, that is the temperature, 20 degree Celsius. Q, and here that is, okay, let me write here, 20 degree Celsius, here minus 10 degree Celsius, and R, it will be 10 degree Celsius. So we can think that this is a cold place. Okay, this is a cold place in general. The climate is cold climate. Now let us take the options. So as per the options, people inhabiting the given place, inhabiting the given place mostly wear cloths made of fiber sourced from some mammals. So yes, this one is correct, because they need it, because they are staying in the cold climate. Okay. Then the given area receives precipitation in the form of rain at the time of Q, and precipitation in snow at the time of P and R. No, this one is incorrect, because there may will be snowfall at 10 minus 10 degrees Celsius, that is at Q. Okay, and in P and R there may be rain. So this one is incorrect. Plants like mango and peepal, animals like kangaroo, rat and fennec, fox are commonly found at this place. No, they are not the plant and animals to be found in cold climates. Okay, next. Plants inhabiting this place have thin broad leaves and of which lack stomata, whereas animals of this area show bright coloration and possess thin moist glandular skin. No, this one is also incorrect. Okay, so in hot climate, the leaves lack stomata to preserve, to reduce the water loss. Okay, and animals in this area, they possess, they should possess a thick skin, fur, okay, or maybe the blubbers, these are required. So here the correct answer is option A. Coming to the next question, the given diagram shows the position of water plants P, Q, R and X in a pond. Four pupils, Vikas, Silpi, Veena and Rahul, were asked to identify the position of four plants. Water has seen hydrilla, coontail and water lily in the pond. Which of these pupils have identified the position of all the given water plants correctly? A. Vikas, P, Q, R, S, B. Silpi, S, P, Q, R, C. Veena, P, S, Q, R, D. Rahul, Q, P, S, R. So here the correct answer is option C. So water hyacinth, that is the P, it is present in this upper surface. Okay. Then coming to hydrilla, that is S, which is present at the bottom. Then coontail, Q, which is present in the middle portion. Then water lily, R, it starts from the bottom the flowers are present little upper to the surface of the water. Okay, so here the correct answer is option C. Coming to the next question, Rima tested the properties of four objects P, Q, R and S and tabulated her results as follows. Select the option that correctly identifies any two of these objects. Option A, Q, steel container, R, styrofoam cup, B, P, rubber mat, S, aluminium plate, C, P, windscreen, R, clay pot, D, Q, ceramic tile, S, rubber band. And the properties of objects are given like flexible, waterproof, transparent, good conductor of heat, breaks easily. Okay, so flexible, and flexible means we can, when we apply force, it will change the shape. Okay, then again when we withdraw the force, when we stop applying the force, it will come to the original space. Okay, so it is flexible. Then waterproof, that is water cannot pass through it. Transparent, light can pass through it. Good conductor of heat, heat can pass through it. Breaks easily. So when it falls, it can break easily. So we have to find out the correct option. So as per the given options, the correct option is option B. P, that is the rubber mat. Yes, it is flexible and it is waterproof, but it is not transparent, not good conductor of heat. It does not break easily. Then aluminium foil, that is S, it is not flexible. Okay, and waterproof, yes, it is waterproof, but it is not transparent. Aluminium is a metal, so it is good conductor of heat. and it does not break easily. So correct answer is option B. Coming to the next question, a pendulum box when released from position X hits a plastic cup on ground and toppled it to its side. Which one of the following correctly shows the conversion of energy that took place in this experiment? A. Potential energy of the pendulum box, kinetic energy of pendulum box, potential energy of plastic cup, then sound energy. B. Potential energy of pendulum box, kinetic energy of pendulum box, kinetic energy of plastic cup, sound energy. C. Kinetic energy of pendulum box, potential energy of plastic cup, then sound energy. D. Kinetic energy of pendulum box, potential energy of pendulum box, kinetic energy of plastic cup, then sound energy. So what is happening here? A pendulum box, when released from position X, hits a plastic cup on the ground and toppled it to its side. So we have to find out which of the following correctly shows the conversion of energy that took place in the experiment. Okay, so X, it is the pendulum. So initially the pendulum was at rest. Okay, so if a substance is present at rest, then it is having potential energy. When it starts moving, then the potential energy of the pendulum bob is converted to kinetic energy of the pendulum bob, and when the bob is moving, the pendulum bob, it is hitting the plastic cup. Okay, so the plastic cup, it will fall down. So now kinetic energy of the pendulum bob, then it will convert to kinetic energy of the plastic cup. Energy is transferring, and when the plastic cup will fall, then there will some sound, and that is conversion to sound energy. So here the correct answer is option B. Coming to the next question, refer to the given Venn diagram and select the incorrect option regarding organs P, Q and R. Option A, P could be a muscular organ which churns the food and helps in mixing with the acid. B, Q receives digestive juices from R and liver for complete digestion of all food component. C, R could be pancreas which secrete different digestive juices for digestion of protein, fat and carbohydrate. D, P could be large intestine which is the longest and widest part of the gut. So, yes, we have to find the incorrect option regarding organ P, Q and R. Now, P could be the muscular organ which churns the food and helps in mixing with acid. So, P is where digestion is taking place, okay, and we secrete digestive enzymes. So yes, P could be a muscular organ which churns the food and helps in mixing with acid. So P, it can be stomach. Okay, now, okay, let me write here, it can be stomach. Next, Q receives digestive juice from R and liver for complete digestion of all food components. A Q, it is an organ where digestion of food takes place. It secretes digestive enzyme organs, then where maximum absorption of digested food takes place. So it is the small intestine. Okay, so Q receives digestive juice from R and liver for complete digestion of all the food components. This one is correct. R could be pancreas which secrete different digestive juices for digestion of protein, fat and carbohydrate. So R is the organ which secrete digestive enzymes, and yes, this is also correct, and can be pancreas, and pancreas, it secretes the digestive enzyme which help in digestion of protein, fats and carbohydrate, all types of food. Okay, then D, P could be large intestine which is the longest and widest part of the gut. No, it is incorrect. P cannot be large intestine because in the P, digestion of food is taking place. In large intestine, no digestion of food is taking place. And the longest part, that is the small intestine. It is not the large intestine. So this one is incorrect. Got it? So this much for today's session. Let's meet you in the next session. Okay, till then read mindfully, practice all the questions properly. Okay, so meet you soon. Bye bye everyone.